Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome University of Pennsylvania President Amy Gutman.
Good afternoon and welcome to the University of Pennsylvania. On behalf of Penn's faculty, our students, and our staff, I am truly honored to welcome back to Penn's campus two awe-inspiring individuals, First Lady Michelle Obama and Dr. Jill Biden. The First Lady and Dr. Biden are among this country's most powerful and most persuasive voices, advocates for finding every way possible to put the path-breaking and important research done at America's great universities to work for humankind. I also extend greetings to so many other eminent guests who are here today that I couldn't venture to begin to name them because I would surely leave someone out. But welcome, everybody, to this important event for a very significant mission. Today, we shine a spotlight on an initiative of critical importance to the men and women of America's military services, returning veterans, and their families. We also underscore the essential role that nursing plays at the front lines of today's healthcare needs. Penn's School of Nursing prepares scientifically educated professionals who are committed to putting the highest levels of research and care into practice. We are honored to be part of this vital initiative to ensure that our nation's veterans and the men and women currently serving in the military forces of this country receive the world-class health care that they deserve. I am proud that researchers from every corner of Penn stand at the forefront of scientific discovery. And that discovery is aimed at answering the needs of this nation's military service members. I am doubly proud that Penn is a leader in targeted research aimed to answer the questions and help address the needs of those who suffer from post-traumatic stress disorder and injury. Today, Penn Nursing joins with other nursing organizations and nursing schools across America. We pledge to prepare nursing professionals to provide the most advanced health care possible for those suffering from combat-related concerns. Many of the serious injuries suffered by our troops who have risked their lives in defense of our country are plainly visible, but many others are not. A grateful nation must find a formidable way to care for them all. We are all honored here today to join the First Lady, Mrs. Obama, and Dr. Biden in making this national pledge to their well-being. Once again, I welcome you to Penn. The program will begin shortly. Thank you all so very, very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Lieutenant Commander Pamela Wall, Dr. Jill Biden, and First Lady of the United States, Mrs. Michelle Obama.
Headed out of town, his breath on the glass. lines with his finger. Map of the roads they go down.
I am absolutely thrilled and honored to welcome First Lady Michelle Obama and Dr. Jill Biden to Penn Nursing. They are here to celebrate the first anniversary of joining forces and to announce the role of nurses in this initiative. I also would like to pay special welcome to all my colleagues who came from across the country, presidents of very important organizations, and deans of nursing. Thank you, welcome to our school. So, Mrs. Obama and Dr. Biden, nurses from Penn and around the United States are here to support joining forces and to support the service people, our veterans, and of course, their families. Nurses in this country are 3 million strong. We are uniquely prepared and positioned to meet the healthcare needs at wartime, at peacetime, in hospitals, in communities, for minorities, for majorities, for women, and for men, and for individuals, and for families. We commend both of you, and thank you both for turning to nurses to improve the care of our military, our veterans, and their families. You have come to the right partners. And also, you have come to the right university. Okay. The number of service people returning from two major wars requires deliberate attention to investigating the best and the most effective practices to alleviate pain, to alleviate suffering, to restore function, to heal trauma. That is what nursing research is all about. You certainly have come to the right partners. Care based on science, it's what nurses do. We care, we advocate, we give voice to patients' needs, we heal injuries, we support families, we integrate people back into their communities and into their families. We also recognize unequal care, and we strive for better access for all, particularly for women and other underserved minorities. Working with our colleagues interprofessionally, physician colleagues, researchers, education partners, nurses tend to attend to the whole person mentally, emotionally, and physically. Post-traumatic stress disorder and the effects of traumatic brain injuries may, and they actually do, manifest themselves differently in the more vulnerable populations. How and why? That's what nursing research is uncovering. Mrs. Obama and Dr. Biden, as you can see from this wonderful gathering in this beautiful hall, we have so many schools of nursing represented here, and they are committed to joining forces, and so many of our leading organizations ready to support educational initiatives to meet the needs of our servicemen and women. So, to both of you, I say on behalf of all of us, you have come to the right partners for your initiative. You have offered your hand to us as nurses, and we are very honored to join you. Through joining forces, we extend our reach to embrace your courage and your forward thinking. We pledge that we can and we will do it. Nurses are always true to their word. After all, nurses win votes too. It's true, the public always votes us as the most trusted profession. And now to the reason that you are all here and what you are waiting for. To hear from our eminent guests. Dr. Biden, it is my absolute honor and pleasure and privilege to introduce you to our distinguished gathering here today. I hear that Jill Biden, when she sees a problem, she fixes it. I love that because that's what nurses do. Jill Biden is a proud Blue Star mom, an active member of her community, and a full-time educator. As a military mom, Dr. Biden understands firsthand how difficult it can be to have a loved one deployed overseas. In Delaware, she was active with a nonprofit organization called Delaware Boots on the Ground, which helps families during times of military deployment by organizing community events to raise awareness and to raise support for the families. Dr. Biden has dedicated herself to shining a light on the military family's strength and courage, as well as the challenges that the military families face. She travels regularly to military bases in both the United States and abroad to speak with service members and their families. Families are usually the unsung heroes of wartime. Through their joining forces initiatives, both Mrs. Obama and Dr. Biden have issued a national challenge to all Americans to take action and find ways to support and engage our military families in their own communities, and to all of us as nurses to provide them with the best health care. Dr. Biden, we are thrilled to have you here at the University of Pennsylvania School of Nursing. Please join me in giving a real warm welcome to Dr. Biden.
Thank you, Dr. Melise, for that kind introduction. I can see you're a great educator. It's great to be here in Philadelphia to mark the 1 year joining forces anniversary. Many of you know that I'm a proud military mom. One of the best parts of my role as second lady is spending time with so many veterans and military families. And I've traveled around the country and the world, and I'm always inspired by the strength and resilience of military families. Our military families have done so much for our country, and each of us can do something in return. That's why the First Lady and I started joining forces last year, so that every American can take action to honor and support our military families. The federal government is doing its part. And as we've seen all across the country this past year, companies, stores, churches, schools, individuals are all stepping up to support military families. We have asked a lot of our servicemen and women since September 11, 2001. They and their families have responded to the need for more frequent and longer deployments. As they have done in the past, these troops and their families have stepped up with no complaint. We know that some of our returning veterans and wounded warriors face significant challenges when they come home. We have seen a growing number of veterans returning with post-traumatic stress and traumatic brain injury. Making sure that they get the care they need is a priority for this administration and for joining forces. That's why I'm so pleased to be here today for this announcement. Nurses represent America's largest healthcare workforce. Many of you know that I'm a community college professor, and I've had the great privilege over the years of teaching countless nursing students. And I have to tell you, they're always my A students. I know just how dedicated nurses are to their profession. Nurses are on the front lines in providing life-saving care in nearly every community. And this is critical because only half of our veterans seek care through the VA system. Nurses are vital to ensuring that all our veterans receive the care they need and deserve. More than 500 nursing schools and more than 150 nursing organizations are joining forces to make sure our nurses are prepared to meet the unique health needs of service members, veterans, and their families. The leading nursing schools and nursing organizations have committed to educate current and future nurses on how to recognize and treat post-traumatic stress, traumatic brain injury, depression, and other combat-related issues. This joining forces commitment means there will be more than 3 million nurses ready to meet the needs of our brave men and women. This is absolutely essential to ensuring our returning service members and their families receive the care they deserve. Thank you for this tremendous effort. Our military families deserve the very best efforts of each of us to ease the burdens created by their service to our country. It is our sacred obligation to show our military families that we truly appreciate their sacrifices on our behalf. Before I close, I want to give a special thank you to my good friend and partner in this effort, First Lady Michelle Obama. She is a committed, caring advocate who has done so much for our military families. Thank you, Michelle. And now I am so pleased to introduce Lieutenant Commander Pamela Wall, a nurse who understands firsthand the kinds of wounds we are talking about today. She joined the U.S. Navy Corps in 1996 as a nurse and has served at military medical facilities around the world. As a pre-doctoral student at the University of Pennsylvania, her research is focused on traumatic brain injury. Thank you, Pamela, for your service. And now please join me in welcoming Lieutenant Commander Wall. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Biden, for your kind introduction and for all of your leadership in joining forces. And thank you for being a Blue Star Mom. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, good afternoon and welcome. My name is Lieutenant Commander Pamela Herbig Wall. As a member of the United States Navy Nurse Corps for the past 16 years, and as a psychiatric nurse practitioner, I have provided care to hundreds of military service members and their families. Military nursing is a time-honored profession, one that combines a warrior ethos with the compassionate care of our nation's wounded, ill, and injured. The nurses that serve in the military and in other facilities across America are healers of mind, body, and spirit. They are ambassadors of hope and respected health professionals. As of this date, more than 2 million service members have deployed to Operation Enduring Freedom, Operation Iraqi Freedom, and Operation New Dawn. Almost half of them have deployed more than once. Many have seen intense ground combat or have been providers taking care of patients with polytraumatic wounds. As a result, nurses like myself in federal healthcare facilities, community clinics, hospitals, and doctor's offices are seeing many more occurrences of physical wounds, pain, traumatic brain injury, post-traumatic stress, and other mental health issues in our service members and veterans. That is why it is so critical that America's nurses get the education and information they need to recognize and treat these conditions. I have seen firsthand the difference this kind of training can make in the care that our veterans and military families receive. 8 months after my graduation from school here at the University of Pennsylvania, I was in theater on a combat mental health stress team. A young service member who was on his third deployment came to my clinic because he had a flashback after watching a training video of an improvised explosive device or IED. On his previous deployment, he was wounded by an IED while driving his Humvee and was subsequently returned stateside for treatment of his physical wounds. He did not identify any symptoms of traumatic stress until after watching that video 1 year later. It was important to him that his treatment would not interfere with his mission. I used the clinical training that I received from my mentor here at the Philadelphia Veterans Administration and was able to provide him with the neurobiological correlates of a stress reaction. This helped him to understand that his reaction was an expected outcome to the video and as a result of his personal experiences. Brief cognitive and behavioral interventions were provided, all while maintaining him on full duty. Because I had this targeted education, I was able to offer this young man the help that he needed. Without this training, I could have easily misdiagnosed him or responded in a way that was not sensitive to his needs within this military organization. This is why the new Joining Forces initiative is so critically important. I would now like to introduce to you the leader of this great initiative. Please join me in a warm welcome for our nation's First Lady, Mrs. Michelle Obama.
Thank you all so much. Thank you. You all, thank you so much. It's very sweet, very sweet. Well, I can't tell you what a pleasure it is to be here with all of you today and to feel this enthusiasm. This is good stuff. I want to start by thanking Dr. Melisse for her very kind introduction, and I'd like to thank both her and Lieutenant Commander Wall for their outstanding leadership at this university and for the work that they're doing on this effort. And of course, I have to recognize my partner and dear friend, Dr. Jill Biden. I mean, she has just been a tireless advocate for our men and women in uniform. She has been a tremendous partner for joining forces and a tremendous voice, and I am grateful to have her as a partner and as a friend. I also want to recognize Mrs. Lisa Nutter, who is here was here representing both herself and her husband. She had to run, her husband Mayor Nutter, assume you know that. But I was happy she was able to attend and just wanted to acknowledge her today. And I also know that my friend Patrick Murphy, your former congressman and a veteran himself, as well as a champion for veterans and military families, he's here, and I want to thank Patrick for being with us today. And most of all, I want to thank all of the nurses and all of the nursing students who are here with us today. Yes, absolutely. Because whether we're in a hospital or a doctor's office or a community health center, nurses are often the first people we see when we walk through that door, right? And we often spend much more time with nurses than just about any other health professional. And I have seen this again and again in my own life experiences, especially as a mother. Now, I have been fortunate enough to have some terrific doctors, and I am grateful for every last one of them. But when my daughters were born, it was the nurses who spent the most time with me and my husband. They were the first ones to notice when something wasn't right or when we needed a little extra time and attention. And as my girls started to grow, and I took them to all those well baby exams and checkups, it's a lot of them. The nurses always took the time to answer all of my crazy, anxious questions and to put my mind at ease. So quite simply, nurses are the front line of America's healthcare system. Every day, with your hard work, with your skill, your compassion, nurses determine the quality of care that we all receive. So when Jill and I launched Joining Forces and we first started thinking about how to improve healthcare for our veterans and military families, it was very clear that we needed to call on all of you, America's nurses and nursing students. And it is clear from today's announcement that you all have answered the call in a tremendous way. I mean, you all are mobilized and organized, and because of your hard work, 3 million, and that number, 3 million nurses will get the training that they need to better support our men and women in uniform and their families. Now, when you think about it, it's not surprising that America's nurses came through in this way, because we all know that nurses get things done. Ask any doctor. They don't know what they're doing, do they? We are also thrilled to be announcing this commitment as we celebrate the 1 year anniversary of Joining Forces. This was excellent timing, because the fact is, your work is more critical for our veterans and military families than ever before. As all of you know and have heard from our speakers, that while the majority of our troops and veterans return home with few or no mental health challenges at all, and that's important to note, many do experience the so-called invisible wounds of war. Since 2000, more than 44,000 of our troops have sustained at least moderate traumatic brain injuries, and studies show that as many as 1 in 6 Iraq and Afghanistan veterans have reported symptoms of PTSD. Similar numbers have reported signs of post-deployment depression. Now I want to be clear on this point. These combat-related mental health challenges are natural, normal, human responses to the violence of war. They are not in any way a sign of weakness, and they should never be a source of shame or a cause for stigma. But too often, these conditions are misunderstood or misdiagnosed. And also, many of our veterans and military families don't live in military communities, or they don't have a VA hospital nearby. So when they seek help, they often rely on local clinics and hospitals, places where health professionals don't always have the information and training they need to provide the care that America's heroes deserve. But we know that training exists. We know that information is out there. We know that high quality of care is possible, and we see examples every day all across this country. At the University of Detroit Mercy School of Nursing, nursing students are working with engineering students to design devices that will help veterans with disabilities return to the activities they love. And they recently worked with a veteran who had trouble grasping objects and holding his arms steady. And with the device they built for him, he's been able to resume his favorite hobbies and hunting and photography. And that's so important. Nurses were right there. At the San Diego State University School of Nursing, they're helping run a program for troops and veterans and their spouses. During weekend retreats, they work with these couples on restoring their relationships after deployments. And they cover everything from problem solving and communication skills to dealing with trauma and stress. And at the University of South Florida College of Nursing, they're even testing a new therapy to treat PTSD. And one of their patients is a veteran named Josh Thomas. And since returning from Afghanistan, Josh had been suffering from insomnia, anxiety, nightmares, high blood pressure, depression. But after just two therapy sessions, he saw dramatic improvements. And as he put it, and these are his words, he said, "Before the therapy, I didn't feel I had any control over my life or the sinking feeling of drowning. But after the second session, I feel I have some control and am actually swimming and getting somewhere. This therapy changed my life." Those were his words. And ultimately, that's what this new initiative that we're announcing today is all about. It's about ensuring that nurses across this country have that kind of information, have the tools, and also the training they need to change the lives of our veterans and military families. And that is the least we can do for the men and women who have served this country so bravely. And I cannot say it again. As Jill said before, these people answer the call. I know we have a number of these wonderful heroes with us today. So to all of you and our men and women in uniform all across the country who may be watching this, I want to send a very clear message to all of you, particularly on this issue. No matter what you're going through, America will be there for you and your families. That's what this is about. And Jill and I have seen it. People are ready to step up for you. So if you need help, don't be afraid to ask for it, because we also know that that's your training too. You don't ask for help, and you handle things so well, but don't be afraid. If you know someone else who's struggling, encourage them to get the support they need. Seeking help is not a sign of weakness. In fact, it's a sign of strength. It can set an example for those who served alongside of you, and it can also help eliminate any remaining stigma that surrounds conditions like PTSD and TBI and post-deployment depression. And with the new commitment that we're announcing today, we'll be doing our part to ensure that no matter where you turn to for help, America's single largest healthcare workforce, more than 3 million nurses, will be ready to meet your needs. So ask for help. We want to ensure that no matter where you live, you will find providers who make you feel comfortable, right? That's the first step. We want you to feel comfortable. People who understand your unique challenges and who will give you a level of care that honors your service and your sacrifice. So thank you. And to all of the nurses and nursing students here today and across this country, I want to be clear that we need your leadership, not just in this area, in our hospitals and clinics and doctor's offices. We need your leadership, period, because in addition to being health professionals, you are also neighbors and friends. And active members of your schools and your communities, and we need you to be leaders in those capacities as well when it comes to this issue. We need you to educate people about the challenges that our veterans and military families are facing. As you learn and grow, we need you to spread the word. We need you to work with your employers to better support our veterans as they transition to civilian life. We need you to work with teachers and coaches and youth group leaders to help them understand that our military kids are going through a lot as well. All of you have a critically important role to play in this mission, and it's not just because you are nurses, but because you all are good citizens, and you have that compassion. That's why we have made this new initiative a centerpiece of our work through Joining Forces, because With your expertise as nurses, we know that people will listen to you. People will listen to you. We know that people will trust what you have to say. And we know that by joining forces with all of you and millions of nurses across this country, we can serve our men and women in uniform and their families as well as they have served this country. That's what this is all about. So I want to once again thank all of you and all of the nursing schools and organizations that are leading the way. This is truly amazing what you're doing, and you're doing work that will have an impact. I mean, just imagine the spouse or the military kid who walks into your office or your clinic or into whatever environment, and they've got somebody who can listen, right? They've got somebody who has training, somebody who has dealt in this world and can make them feel just a little safer. That's our duty. That's the sacred promise, as Jill said, that we have to these men and women in uniform. So I look forward to working with all of you to ensure that our veterans and military families get the world-class care that they deserve. And congratulations on all the work that you are going to do. It is going to be fabulous. I can't wait to see you out there, especially the students. So work hard, get good grades, stay out of trouble. Thank you all, and God bless.